Music producer reveals why he was warned not to work with Jennifer Lopez, before defying advice and crafting the biggest hit of her career. Red One has worked with some of the biggest names in pop, from Lady Gaga and Nicki Minaj to Enrique Iglesias and One Direction. But the Moroccan hitmaker, real name Nader Kayat, was warned against working with Jennifer Lopez before they joined forces on her 2011 mega hit On the Floor. Speaking to the unpopular podcast, Red One revealed that people in the industry told him to steer clear of JLo because her music career was in a slump at the time. "A lot of people heard that I might be maybe considering working with JLo, so everybody's calling me, 'Don't do it, Red. It's not good for your career, you're the hottest producer. Everybody was telling me not to do it. Everybody besides two people. My wife, she told me, 'I think, JLo's an icon. For us women, we all love her, and she just needs one song to take over and you can do it.'" He was also urged by producer and label executive Martin Kirsenbaum to give Lopez a chance. "He told me, 'JLo is a star, she just needs a song,'" Red explained. The hitmaker finally met with JLo and they ended up with On the Floor, which was not only a comeback single for the diva, but also turned out to be the biggest hit of her entire career. The Latin-infused dance track topped the charts in Australia and the UK and reached number 3 on the Billboard Hot 100, where it was certified triple platinum. "We did an incredible and she killed it, JLo is a star, there is no doubt about it," Red said. Before her chart comeback in 2011, Lopez was in a major career slump. She hadn't produced a hit single in over 5 years and her acting career had also cooled down following box office flops like El Cantante and Border Town. However, things started to turn around for the fallen star when she joined American Idol as a judge in 2010. Her stint on the TV talent show turned out to be a huge success, and led to her chart comeback with On the Floor. Lopez's acting career also started to pick up again with roles like The Backup Plan, Ice Age, Continental Drift, and What to Expect When You're Expecting. In more recent years, the Love Don't Cost a Thing hitmaker has co-headlined the Super Bowl halftime show and received widespread critical acclaim for her role in the stripper drama Hustlers. Meanwhile, Red One, along with Boyzone founder Mark Walton and blockchain entrepreneur David DeVito, just announced the launch of their new joint venture, SpotStar. Built on a blockchain, SpotStar is a digital global talent show that connects musical artists directly to their fans. In addition, it provides record labels of all sizes, from indies to large conglomerates, with an equal opportunity to discover and sign on their next revenue-generating artist. Traditional talent competitions like American Idol and The Voice, as well as those that take place online or via social media platforms, are still extremely limited in terms of finding talent internationally, Red One said in a statement. "Also, based on my experience, at the end of the day, it is the producers, hosts, sponsors, and advertisers that ultimately and disproportionately, compared to the artist, win big financially," he continued. SpotStar is here to solve a much-needed, decades-long, industry-wide problem with a democratized approach ensuring all parties, including fans, benefit financially. Thank you. Lopez's acting career also started to pick up again with roles like The Backup Plan, Ice Age, Continental Drift, and What to Expect When You're Expecting. In more recent years, the Love Don't Cost a Thing hitmaker has co-headlined the Super Bowl halftime show and received